Hello everyone. Today I am going to explain the case study which are related to the principle of management, that is FIOL principle, the FIOL 14 principle. Okay. So here the first case study. Ramesh is the owner of printing press, and the size of his organization has increased during the recent past. There are many employees who work in his organization. The organization is considered good and has increased a lot of reputations in the market. However, when it comes to making key decisions in the organization related to many things, he never considers the opinion of his subordinate. Even though the size of the organization has increased, yet he tries to make all the key decisions on his own. Okay, so what the principle of FIOL has been violated by him. So Ramesh is what? Ramesh is the owner of the printing press. Okay, and he has the control all kind of decisions with himself, not sharing the power among the different sections of the management. Okay, or you can say that sharing the power in others worker. So what kind of the principle is violated? As you know that the principle is what, the centralization and the decentralization. Centralization is what, the power in few hands. So here is a principle is basically violated is what, centralization means they focus on a centralization only, not distributed the power among the societies. Okay, so principle here is violated is here the principle is violated, centralization and decentralization. Okay, centralization and decentralization. Okay, how we know that things are centralized or decentralized? Because when it comes to the making key decision in the organization related to the many things, he never consider the opinion of his subordinate. Means they hold all kind of power with himself, not sharing the power to the other level of the management. So here the principle is violated is what, centralization and the decentralization. Now come to the second case studies. Second case study is what, Mohan work on a floor of a mall managers. As a managers, he is very hard working, but he is unable to produce a result for his organization. His target for the last month was sale of 10 lakh rupees from his floor. However, by end of the month, the sale was only 8 lakh rupees. He is very regular and take all the necessary steps to complete the target. However, his staff is not as complete as he himself is. When he tried to take action against the disobedient employee, the top management doesn't allow him to do so. They haven't given him the power to fire employees or take any strict actions against them. So which principle is violated here by the organizations? As you clearly see that here, the performance of the worker is not good as much the requirement of the organizations, but he tried to make the actions against the disobedient. Some employee are disobedient, not follow the regulations, rule or regulations set by the manager. So and the top level manager doesn't allow him to do so, and top level also favoring the workers also. They haven't given him the power to fire, power to take decisions. Power to take decision is what? Authority. Okay? As you know, there is the second principle of the management, authority and responsibilities. So here there is no any power to take any kind of decision in the organization, either the worker is performing or not. So here the principle is violated is what? Authority and the responsibility. We have to write both the things. Okay? okay? Not only the authority, because principle is what? Authority and responsibility. Not only the authority. So you have to write authority and the responsibility is the principle validity. Why is it right there? Because they don't have any kind of power to fire the employee. Either they are doing the work or not. Okay? Now, come to the third case studies. I hope you understood the things. Come to the third case studies. Enlightened Souls Private Limited is a tube light manufacturing company. Before the start of the years, they have to promise their employee for bonus for extra production. It was also decided that those who will put extra time will get extra paid extra according to the number of hours. Okay. So, how are the people in the HR department who work very hard later complained that they are not compensated for the extra number of hours that they used to stay in the office. Okay, which principle of the fuel is violated? As you see that here, discipline means no clear instructions, or you can say there is no clear dialogues between the workers and the management. Okay, here in this case studies here, company give the extra payment for the extra work, but he denied when when the work has been done. Okay, so here the principle of discipline is violated in this case study. Okay, so right here this principle is violated is what? Because a department is hard work and going to the extra work. So according to that, we have to write what? Discipline as a principle violated over here. Now come to the next case studies, that is Rohan and Amit are working in the purchase department of the company. Rohan is the brothers-in-law of the managing director of the company, and where the Amit is the recruitment from the external sources. Okay, so Rohan is a brother-in-law of managing director, and Amit is a external source, recruiter as external. They both have been performing below average for the last couple of the month. Many people in the organization talk about their lack of the responsibility. When the managing director of the companies came to know about their irresponsible behavior, he immediately suspended Amit but did not take any actions against the Rohan. So what kind of the principle is violated over here? So principle of equity, because they're not treated as a both as an inefficient worker. He only treated that he suspended Amit, not Rohan. So Amit, so here is what kind of the principle is violated? Principle is equity. How is equity? Equity means what? Equity means we have to give the fair wages, fair and we have to, there is no discriminations according to their caste, gender or their relative or any kind of the, they just only focus on the performance of the organization. They are performing in the organization or not, only focusing on the direction. But here Amit is suspended because both are not doing the lack of responsibility in the organization. But only Amit is sacked from the organization, but Rohan is a favor because Rohan is a relative of the MD, so he is favoring, and Amit is suspended from the job. Okay, so here the principle is violated is what? Equity means there is, you can see there the discrimination between Amit and Rohan. Okay, now come to the next case studies, the last case studies. That is Aditi, who is heading a company recruitment program of the firm that she is working in, and get an immediate order from the marketing heads of the vendor who has 2 years experience in the field of marketing. Okay. And and get the immediate order from the marketing head and UPS is the higher only the those who candidate only 2 year experience in the field of the marketing and offer them in a higher package movement later than when he sees about to enter the campus, he get another call from the HR head who ask her to hire the candidate with zero experience. He gives her the logic that the such candidate would be expecting lower package in the comparison to the candidate having the experience in the industries. So which kind of the principle is violated? So you can see that here the Rupesh is asking to hire only the person who has the 2 years experience, and others manager is saying that the person who have zero years of the experience means they have no any kind of the experience. So what the Aditi will do, he might be confused because someone saying that the person, you have to hire the person those who have 2 years experience, and others saying that you have to hire those who have the zero level of zero, or you can say that 0 years experience means no experience, because those who have the zero experience they get might get low wages or salary as compared to those having the 2 year of the experience. So here the principle is violated is unity of command. Okay, so this how you are recognized, because there are two kind of statements given by the boss. So the workers might be confused, either we have to hire 2 year experience or be focusing on the cutting the labor cost. Okay, so here unity of command means what is the principle said? The unity of command given by only one boss. Okay, so here the principle is violated, unity of command. Okay, hope you understood the concept of how to solve the case studies. Okay, and you solve so many in your book, as well as you can go to mycbseguide.com. You can solve so many case studies. If you have any problem, then you can contact me. Okay, thank you.